following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 7th Chapter, text number 24, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 21st, 1976, in Vrindavan, India.
Saiva jiva lokasya maya mohita chetasa vidatse sena vidyena Shreya Dharmadi Lakshanam. So Krishna, who is described in the previous verse, Tam Adya Purusha, the original person. Original person, absolute truth, that is described in the Vedanta Sutra, Janma Adasya Jataha, original person, just like in our family wise or Guru Parampara wise, there is somebody original person. So, similarly, the whole creation, there is original person. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Aham Asan Agre, Aham Asama Agre. In the Vedanta, Vedic literature, Eka Narayana Asit. So, Eka Narayana Asit, that is original person. And Krishna says, Aham Agre Asit. So he is the original person, Adyam. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said, Param Brahma Param Dhamma Pavitram Paramam Bhava Purusam Adyam. So Krishna is the original person. And if somebody questions that if Krishna is the original person, who is the origin of Krishna? Naturally, we can ask that because our experience is different. That answer is there in the Brahma Samhita. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi Adi. Anadi Adi. He is Adi Adam Purusam. But if you question who is the cause of Krishna, Anadi, he has no cause. That is God. You go on searching after one after another. I am, my origin is my father. My father's origin is his father. His father's origin, his father, his father. In this way, go on searching, then come to Brahma. Brahma is Adi Kavi. In this material world, in this universe, Adi Kavi. Tene Brahma Rida Adi Kavi. So he is Jari Adi, original, first created being. Then who is his Adi, where from Brahma is coming? That is Krishna. Tene Brahma Rida Adi Kave. So, in this way, when we come to Krishna, making a Brahma is coming from Vishnu, Gadbhuduk Sai Vishnu, Swayambhu. He is born of the lotus flower. That Gadbhuduka Sai Vishnu is coming from Karanoduka Sai Vishnu. Karanoduka Sai Vishnu is coming from Sankarsan. Sankarsan is coming from Aniruddha, Aniruddha, from Pradyumna, like that. Ultimately, Krishna. Therefore, Krishna is Adyam. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Matra Parataram Nanya. There is no word. Well, that is God. You go on researching, Adyam, Adyam, Adyam. When you come to a point, there is no more Adyam. Well, that is God. Ishara Paramakrishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi Radi Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam. Saiva, that Adi Purush, that original person, he comes down, descends in this material world. Jiva Loka Sa. This is called Jiva Loka. This material is called Jiva Loka because here Atma, the soul is covered, conditioned. We have given the meaning Jiva Loka means when the Atma is conditioned, that is called Jiva Loka. There is no freedom. Just like there are so many planets. You have got aeroplane, but because you have got aeroplane, you cannot go there. Condition. You cannot go. They're trying one, two planets, moon planet or Mars planet. No, you cannot go there. What to speak of other planets? If you want to go there, then you have to qualify yours. Not that because you have got a machine, you can go there. No, that is not possible. Therefore, condition. Condition means you have to fulfill the condition. Just like from here, if I want to go to America, then I have to fulfill the condition. The visa condition, the passport condition, the health condition, the custom condition, so many conditions. You cannot go immediately. Or nobody can come from there also. In every respect we are conditioned. Every respect. This body is conditioned. You cannot enjoy this body unconditionally. No, that is not possible. You have to change. Dehi nasmin yatha dehi, kaumarang jauvanang jara. The body has to be changed. A baby has to be changed to become a boy. A boy has to be changed to become a young man. A young man has to be changed to an old man. You cannot stop that. Therefore, it is called Jiva Loka, condition. Every one of us is conditioned. animal is conditioned. He cannot, there are so many animals in the jungles. They are conditioned. They cannot come in the city or in the town. We are conditioned. We cannot go to the jungle. Condition. Every state there is condition. So that is our bondage. We are Mamaimamsa Jiva Bhuta. We are part and parcel of Krishna. Why you are conditioned? The condition is because Maya Mohita Chetasa. Maya Mohita. They are bewildered by Maya. Maya means what is not. Maya. So, because we are under the clutches of Maya, this material world, therefore we have been conditioned. And what is that Maya? That Maya is forgetfulness of our relationship with God. That is Maya. Krishna bhuliya, jeev bhogavancha kare. This jeev. When we forget Krishna, our relationship with Krishna, what is the relationship? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, jiver swarupai nitya Krishna das. That is our relationship. We are eternal servant of Krishna. When we forget this, and we want to be master of all I serve, I am the monarch of all I serve, I think I shall become independent and I shall enjoy, I shall improve my economic condition and I shall be very happy. This is called Maya Mohita Chaitas. He will never be, because he is conditioned. Suppose the pig, he is conditioned to live in a very filthy place and eat stool, urine. You cannot improve that condition. By philanthropic mentality, if you want to improve his condition, not to live in filthy place, not to eat stool, if you try to give them halwa instead of stool, they cannot. That is not possible. This is called condition. Therefore, Shastra says that you are conditioned, you cannot change the condition, so there is no need of endeavoring for changing the condition. That is not possible. Devi jesa gunamai mama maya durutvaya, Krishna says. Maya mama maya durutvaya. It is not that. Suppose if you are in the prison house, you are sacred. You cannot improve your condition. You must be sacred. You are put in a cell. You must live there. Similarly, this is useless effort. The so-called Maya Mahita Chetasa. The whole material world is like that. They are trying to improve the condition. But that is not possible. Therefore they are called Maya Mahita Chetasa. Simply, he is thinking that if I do like this, if I go a step forward, I shall improve my condition. No, that is not possible. Again and again, they describe in another place that nati vidu sarthaka tinghi vishno durasayaji bahirathamanina andajatha puna puna char vitacharvanana matinna krishne parato sato va mitho vipaddita grihabhritana Grihabhritana matinna krishne. Those have taken it a vow that I shall remain in this family life and improve my condition. Grihabhritana, grihabhrita, grihastha and grihabhrita are different. Grihastha means grihastha ashram. A man is living with husband and wife or children. But the aim is how to improve spiritual life. That is grihastha ashram. And one who has no such aim, he simply wants to enjoy the senses, and for that purpose he is decorating the house, decorating the wife, children. That is called grihabhrita. Or grihamedhi. In Sanskrit, there are different terms for different meanings. So, those who are grihabhrita, they cannot be Krishna conscious. Matinna krishne parato satova. Parato means, by the instruction of guru or instruction of authority, parato. And satova, sato means automatically. Automatically is not possible, even by instruction. Because his vow is that I shall remain in this way, Grihabratam. Matinna Krishna Parato Satho Va Mitho Vipaddi Mitho. But by conference, by meeting, by passing resolution, if we want to become Krishna conscious, that is not possible. It is all individual. I have to surrender to Krishna individually. Just like when you go to the sky on aeroplane, it is all individual. If one aeroplane is in danger, other aeroplane cannot save you. That is not possible. Similarly, it is all individual. It is not parato satova. One has to take it seriously, personally, that Krishna wants, so I will surrender. Krishna says, sarvadharmān parityajya māmekam saraṇam vraja, so I will do it. Not that when my father will do, then I shall do, or my husband will do, then I shall do, or my wife will do. No, it is all individual. It is all individual. And there is no restraint. There is no restraint. Ohituki apratihata. If you want to surrender to Krishna, nobody can check you. Ohituki apratihata. Jino atma samprasidati. When you do that individually, collectively, if it is done, it is good. But it has to be done individually. So, because every one of us are maya-mahita-cetam. Maya-mahita-cetam. Prahlad Maharaj has described vimukha-cetasa. Maya-mahita-cetasa means averse to Krishna. I want everything except Krishna. That is maya-mahita-cetam. I want everything but except Krishna. That is my missing point. Because we are rascal fools, we do not know what we should want. Nate vidu sarthagatim hi Vishnu. He does not know that his actual want is Krishna. Just like a small child crying, and we are trying to pacify him, giving this, giving that, but he is crying. Because his actual want is his mother. And as soon as the mother comes, takes the child on the lap, immediately he stops. Similarly, we want Krishna because we are part and parcel of Krishna. That we want. Just like a part and parcel of a machine. If it is taken away from the machine, it has no one screw. Suppose your typewriter machine, one screw is missing and the machine is not working nicely. So without the machine, that one screw has no value. If it is lying somewhere, one does not know what is the screw, nobody cares for it. It is no worth. But if you want to complete the machine, if you want to go to purchase it in a mechanical shop, that very screw, which has no value, you have to purchase at 10 rupees. Because it is to be fit up. In this way, we are person and parcel of Krishna, part and parcel of Krishna. When we are along with Krishna, we have got value. Otherwise, no value. There are so many examples. This finger, when it is attached to the body, if there is any trouble, you can spend thousands of rupees to cure the trouble. But if the finger is cut off, amputated, and thrown on the street, it is no value. No value. Similarly, so long we are maya mahita cetasa, out of Krishna's touch, we have no value. No value. Valueless. Useless. That is our position. Matinna Krishna parato satova. Mitho. The position is that Adanta Govi Visatang Tamisram. When we forget Krishna, what is that forgetfulness? When you are interested in sense gratification, that is called forgetfulness. Everyone is, even an animal, a small insect, everyone is interested in sense enjoyment. Just this morning I was reading in the Bhagavata, one Shobhari Muni, he was a great yogi, and within the water he was executing the yoga mystic, and he saw that the two fishes are enjoying sex. So he became sexually inclined, old man, yogi. So he went to Mandata king that, you give me one daughter, your daughter. So he was within the water, old man, and old man's bodily feature is not very good. The king knew that this is a useless person, but he is a yogi. He has come to ask me for a daughter. So he said that, yes, you are welcome. I have got my 50 daughters. So anyone will like you, he can accept. I have no objection. So Shobhari Muni understood that the king has tactfully avoided to give his daughter. So he was a yogi. So he made himself very beautiful young man. That yogi can do that. They can change, because we are not this body. The body is old, it can be younger, younger, but it can be older. Nowadays, in medical science, they are also doing. A man, an old man is man. body can be changed. There is no difficulty if you know the process. So he changed to be very nice, beautiful young man. So all the 50 daughters, they become attracted. They began to fight. Oh, he is for me. He's not for you. So anyway, he accepted all the 50 daughters. In this way, he became very elevated householder. But at some time he began to think, what is my this enjoyment? Simply by seeing the sex appears of the fish, I was a yogi, I was a tapasvi, I have lost everything. Now I am a householder and pet husband of this woman. So he came to his senses. Again he went to the forest for tapasya. So this material life, however opulent it may be, it is maya mahita cetas. It is no value. It has no value. Why? Because in this life I may be very favorably situated by arrangement, by improving my material condition. But after death, dehantara prapti, you do not know. We do not know what kind of body we are going to get. It may not be as comfortable. The Kurmis, those who are little advanced than the ordinary foolish persons, there are, first of all, ordinary foolish person means animals. They are just like animals. A little above that, they are Kurmis. A little above that, there are Gyanis. A little above that, there is yogis. And above all of them is the bhakti. That the bhakta life is the samam bhonam of life. So Krishna comes here, saiva jiva lokasya mamahita cetasa vidhase sena vityena. Krishna comes down. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita also, yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati. The dharma is, I am servant of Krishna. That is my position. Dharma means characteristic. Just like sugar has to become sweet, that is dharma. Chili has to be hot. A sugar, if it is chili taste, it is useless. A chili is sweet taste, it is useless. So this taste of a particular thing is called dharma. So this dharma, according to the body, is developed in this material world. But the original dharma, original is the spirit soul. That spirit soul is the part and parcel of Krishna, and his duty is to serve Krishna. That is original dharma. So in order to teach that original dharma, Krishna comes. Jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati. Glani means discrepancy. When the conditioned soul is, by the influence of maya, is engaged in sense gratification, that is called dharmasya glani. Jada jada hi, you know, just like nowadays, nobody is interested. The so-called educated or advanced man, if we say that you have to serve Krishna, this is not your duty. You are going to the office and handling daily 5,000 rupees, that is simply useless. Useless. It is simply waste of energy. We'll believe it. No, this is a nonsense proposal. But Shastra says, that dharmasyana sthita pungsa visyakshena kathasuja notpadaya dharati jadi samayi vahi kevalam. You are doing your duty very nicely. Your dharma means an occupational duty. Suppose you are an engineer. You are doing duty very nicely. Or a medical man, or a businessman, or anyone. Everyone has to do something. You cannot sit down idly and you get your livelihood. Even if you are a lion, you have to work. Nahi suptasya singasya prabhishanti mukhe mriga. This is the material world is like that. Even if you are as powerful as a lion, you cannot sleep. If you think, I am lion, I am the king of the forest, let me sleep, and the animal will come and enter in my mouth. No, that is not possible. Even if you are animal, you have to catch up the animal, then you will be able to eat. Otherwise, you will have to starve. Therefore, Krishna says, niyata kuru karma tyam karma jyayo akarmana. You must do your duty. Sarira jatra pite na prasiddhe tapno. Don't think, the rascal says the Krishna consciousness movement is teaching people to escape. That becomes, no, that is not Krishna's instruction. We do not allow any lazy man. He must be engaged. That is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna's order. Niyata kuru karma. Arjuna was refusing to fight. He was trying to be non-violent gentleman. Krishna did not allow him. No, you cannot do that. That is your weakness. Kutasre kasmalamidam visamesam. You are proving yourself rascal. It is anarja system. This kind of proposal is for the anarja, uncivilized man. Don't do that. That is Krishna. So don't think that Krishna consciousness movement, those who are Krishna conscious, they become lazy and imitate Haridas Thakur. That is not Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness means, as Krishna instructs, you must be very, very busy 24 hours. That is Krishna consciousness. Not to become a lazy fellow, eat and sleep. No. So, this is dharmasya glani. But you have to change your angle of vision. In the material conditioned life, your aim is how to satisfy your senses. And Krishna consciousness means you have to work in the same spirit, same vigor, but you have to satisfy Krishna. That is spiritual life. Not that to become lazy fellow. The difference is, as it is said by author Krishnadas, Atmendriya Tripti Mancha Taranam Kaam. What is Kaam? Kaam means when one desires to satisfy his own senses. That is Kaam. Krishnandriya Tripti Mancha Dhare Prem Na. And what is Prem? Prem means when you engage to yourself for satisfying Krishna's senses. Why gopis are exalted? Because their only endeavor was to satisfy Krishna's senses. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended, Brahma Kachi Upasana Brajamadhu Varga Bhija Kalipita. They had no other business. Vrindavan means, those who are in Vrindavan, they actually want to live in Vrindavan, their business would be how to satisfy the senses of Krishna. That is Vrindavan. And not that I am living in Vrindavan and trying to satisfy my senses. That is not Vrindavan verse. That kind of living is, there are so many monkeys, dogs and hawks also. They are in Vrindavan. Do you mean to say that they are living in Vrindavan? No. Anyone who wants to satisfy senses in Vrindavan, their next life is dogs, hawks and monkeys. You must know that. So one should not try to sense gratify in Vrindavan. That's a great sin. Simply try to satisfy Krishna's sense. Sarvapadhi vinin muktam tat paratena nirmalam rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti ruchyate. That is bhakti. Rishikena rishikesa sevanam. So, in order to teach this lesson to us, the conditions of jivaloka, Krishna vidhase sena vidjena, by his own potency. One potency means, if you surrender to Krishna, he has got such potency, he can deliver you from this conditioned life, jiva. He can make you purified, pure mukti, that is called mukti. When you are free from this conditioned state, this bodily conception of life, then you become free, simply by understanding Krishna. Janma karmansa divam me jo janati takta deham punar janma nahi. After giving up this body, he does not get any more of this material body. Then what happens to him? But takta deham punar janma nahi mameti. Krishna comes to call you back. So if he comes back, if you take Krishna's instruction, you go back to Krishna, and again you become happy. Otherwise, maya mohita cetasa, you will have to suffer life after life. Thank you very much.